This is the story dedicated to my teachers, Silveria and Patty. They met the spiffiest giant in town. The Spiffiest Giant in Town by Julia Donaldson. John was a giant, the scruffiest giant in town. He always wore the same pair of old brown sandals and the same old patch-up gown. "I wish I wasn't the scruffiest giant in town," he said sadly. But one day, George noticed a new shop. It was full of spiffy clothes, so he bought a spiffy shirt, a spiffy pair of pants, spiffy belt, a spiffy striped tie, some spiffy socks with diamond side, and a pair of spiffy giant shoes. Now in the spiffiest giant in town, George left his old clothes behind the shop. He was about to go home when he heard a sound. On the sidewalk stood a giraffe who was sniffing sadly. "What's the matter?" asked George. "It's my neck," said the giraffe. "It's so very long and so very cold. I wish I had the long scarf. "Cheer up," said George, and he took off his striped tie. "I didn't match my socks anyway," he said, as he walked it around and around the giraffe's neck. It made a wonderful scarf.
"Thank you," said the giraffe.
As George stood toward home, he said to himself, "My tie is a scarf for a cold giraffe. But look me up and down, I'm the spiffiest giant in town." George came to a river. On a boat stood a goat who was belting the loudly.
"What's the matter?" asked George.
"It's my sail," said the goat. "It blew away in a storm. I wish I had a strong new sail for my boat."
"Cheer up," said George, and he took off his new white shirt. "It kept on coming untucked anyway," he said as he tied it to the mast of the goat's boat. It made a magnificent sail.
"Thank you," said the goat. George strolled on, singing to himself. "My tie is a scarf for a gold giraffe. My shirt and a boat is a safe for a goat. But look me up and down, I'm the spiffiest giant in town."
George came to a tiny ruined house. Beside the house stood a white mouse with the lots of baby mice. They were all squeaking.
"What's the matter?" asked George.
"It's someone's house," squeaked the mouse. "It's burning down and now we have nowhere to live. I wish we have a nice new house."
"Cheer up," said George, and he took off one of his shiny shoes. "It was giving my blisters anyway," he said, as the mouse and her babies scrambled inside.
"These shoes make a perfect home for them."
"Thank you," they squeaked. George had to hop along the road now. But he didn't mind. As he hoped, he said to himself, "My tie is a scarf for a cold giraffe. My shirt and a boat is a safe for a goat. My shoes is a house for a little my mouse. But look me up and down, I'm the spiffiest giant in town."
George came to a campsite. Beside the tent stood a fox, who was crying. "What's the matter?" asked George. "It's my sleeping bag," said the fox. "I dropped in a puddle. I wish I had a warm, dry sleeping bag." "Cheer up," said George, and he took off one of his socks with diamonds on the sides. "It was tickling my toes anyway," he said, as the fox snuggled into it. "It made a very fine sleeping bag."
"Thank you," said the fox.
George hopped on, singing to himself, "My child's scarf will hold you up. My search on the boat is safe for a goat. My chest is a house for a little white mouse. But one of my socks is a bed for a fox. But look me up and down. I'm the spiffiest giant in town." George came to a big squishy bug. Beside the bug stood a dog, who was howling.
"What's the matter?" asked George.
"It's this bug," said the dog. "I need to get across, but I keep getting stuck in the mud.
Oh, oh,
I wish there was a safe, dry path.
Whoa, whoa."
"Cheer up," said George, and he took off his spiffy new belt. "It was squeezing my tummy anyway," he said as he laid it down over the bug. "It made an excellent path."
"Thank you," said the dog.
"Oh, oh." The wind started to blow, but George didn't mind. He hopped on, singing to himself, "My child's a scarf for a cold you wash. My shirt's on a boat as a safe for a goat. My shoes is a house for a little white mouse. One of my socks is a bed for a fox. My belt helped a dog who was crossing a bog. But..."
"My pants are falling down. I'm the coldest giant in town."
Suddenly, George felt sad and shivering and not all as spiffy. He stood on one foot and thought, "I have to go back to the shop and buy some more clothes," he decided. He turned around and hopped all the way back to the shop. But when he got there, it was closed.
"Oh no,"
cried George. He sank down onto the sidewalk and a tear ran down his nose. He felt as sad as all the animals he had met on his way home. Then, out of the corner of his eyes, he saw a bag with something familiar poking out of the top. George took a closer look.
"My gown," he yelled. "My dear old gown sandals."
George put them on. They felt wonderfully comfortable.
"I'm the cosiest giant in town," he cried, and danced back home along the road.
Outside his front door stood all the animals he had helped. They were carrying an enormous present.
"Come on, George," they said. "Open it."
George yanked the ribbon. Inside was a beautiful gold paper crown and a card.
"Look inside the card, George," said the sad animals.
George put another crown on his head and opened the card. Inside, it said, "You get your scarf for a cold, you wrap your shirts on a boat as a safe for a goat. Your shoes is a house for a little white mouse. One of my socks is a bed for a fox. Your belt have a bug who was crossing a bog. So here's a very fine crown. to go the sandals and gown of the kindest dining town.
Bye!